Hello children, welcome to our English teacher video lessons. In the previous session, we have learnt about phrasal verbs, no children? Have you gone through them? If you haven't gone through them, go through all those phrasal verbs once again and try to use them in your daily conversation, children. Not only those phrasal verbs, try to pick up whatever that you come across while reading printed matter or while listening to the spoken English and use them in your conversation and also in your creative writing, children. Okay, do it. Shall we move to our next session, children? What is an extra item and your grammar in the third unit, children? Yeah, direct and indirect speech. Okay, it's not at all difficult task to change the statements or questions or orders or exclamatory sentences into reported speech, children. We shall go one by one in detail. Before going into this direct indirect speech, I would like to ask you one thing, children. Do you know what direct speech mean or indirect speech mean? It's very easy. Whatever you talk, suppose if I write or say as it is without changing even a single word, that's nothing but direct speech. Just let us take one example. We need not go anywhere for examples. We can take examples from our daily conversation that goes in your classrooms or that goes among you in playground, children. Generally, just imagine the situation. When you were absent the previous day, what would your headmaster or class teacher ask you? Very simple question. Why were you absent yesterday? Isn't it, children? Then what would be your answer? Yeah, I was suffering from fever. My mother suffered from headache. I went to somewhere. I went to attend my cousin's marriage. I went to attend my uncle's daughter's function. Likewise, okay? Here, you have so many examples as statements given by your friends or by your classmates or by your seniors or juniors. Okay, children? Right. Here, just let us take one example. What would be your reason for your absence? Just take one example. My mother suffered from fever. Suppose if I write the same example as it is on the blackboard, I put it within the inverted commas. My mother suffered from fever. My mother suffered from fever. Let us take this example once. My mother suffered from fever. And it is the statement given by one of you. My mother suffered from fever. It is the statement given by one of you, children. Here, look at the inverted commas. That statement should be within the inverted commas. Why? It is not my statement or your statement. Let us take one example here, Ravi. For our convenience, Ravi said. Who said this statement? Ravi said, my mother suffered from fever. Then it is the statement given by Ravi. Without changing even a single word, as it is, I have written it on the board. As Ravi's statement. Okay? Now, let us see. I would like to report this statement, Ravi's statement, to you children. How would I report it to you? Ravi said that my becomes his mother had suffered from fever. His mother had suffered from Ravi said that his mother had suffered from fever. Now children, look at the changes that take place here while changing the statement given in direct speech into indirect speech. Ravi said that one conjunction has been added. My becomes his, suffered becomes had suffered. So some changes take place while changing direct speech into indirect speech. We shall go in detail one after one, children. Okay, before going to change this direct speech into indirect speech, you should have some points in your mind, children. What are those points? You should know what be forms are, and you should have an idea of possessive forms, and you should have idea of tenses, and you should have knowledge of pronouns of four forms. What are the four forms of pronouns? Subjective form, objective form, possessive form, reflexive forms. When you know all these things, it becomes easy and you can change any sentence given in direct speech into indirect speech. But now we are in 9th class and most of you may not have the idea of all these things. So I would like to revise all these things once for your convenience, children. Now, what are be forms? Some of you may know, but some of you may not be aware of these be forms. Be forms means it's nothing but a kind of verb forms. Being, being, B1, B2 forms are there. Suppose if I say, there is a board, is this be form. You are children, R is be form. I was absent yesterday, was is be form. I'm a teacher, I'm is a be form. Isn't it, children? Here we use be forms in both present tense and past tense. Be forms which we use in present tense, for our convenience, we can call them as B1. And be forms which we use in past tense, for our convenience, we can call them as B2. Now let us see what comes under B1. Am, is, are. Suppose if I say, I'm a teacher. It's not a sentence that's being used in past tense. It is used in, yes, we use it in present tense. I'm a player. She is a singer. She is a dancer. He is a sportsman. So, am comes. When do we use this am? Yeah, first person. When you speak about yourself, you use am. Speakers uses am. And third person, when we talk about third person, yeah, we use is, he is, she is. And third person plural, they are. Second person, you are. So all these be forms we use in present tense. Now let us come to past tense be forms. Was, were. Yesterday I was absent. yesterday, past tense. He was absent. She was absent. And suppose if we want to say about two or more than two boys or girls, what do we say? They were absent yesterday. Isn't it, children? It's very easy. It is not okay. Try to understand. And if you are not able to understand, pause the video and come again. Okay, children? Now, so here we can say B1 as am, is, are, commander. B1 was, were, commander. B2 and has, have, had. These are possessive forms. Suppose I would like to say I have. What's it? It's a marker. I have a marker. I have a marker. Possessiveness. Possessing. The things you possess. When you want to say about the things you possess, what do you say? What do you use? I have a black pen. I have a red pen. I have a bag. I have a nice notes. I have a nice pencil. Likewise, no children? I have a water bottle. I have a lunch box. All these, where do we get? From our daily conversation only. From our daily life situations only. Life situations. Yeah. Children, here, has, have, we use these possessive forms in present tense. And we use this had in past tense. And sometimes these be forms or possessive forms act as main verbs. Just as I have given one example. I have this marker. Okay. She is in previous examples. I was absent yesterday. He was absent yesterday. She was absent yesterday. They were absent. In all those cases, these be forms are used as main verbs. And when we want to use them with the action verbs, so suppose if the situation demands, we use these as helping verbs, children. Now let us come to pronouns. These are pronouns. I, we. I, we, all together, we. When we want to refer, yes, along with all of us, what subject do we use here? We. We. And you, listener. And he, she, they. He refers to boys. She refers to girls. They refers to more number of persons. Two or more than two. Okay, children? So here pronouns. These are the subjective forms of pronouns. And again, each one has other form. Objective form, possessive form, reflexive form. We can go in detail whenever the situation demands. Basically, you know what be forms are, what possessive forms are, and what pronouns are. If you keep all these things in your mind, it becomes easier for us to understand while going on. Okay, children? Now, let us see. Here, I would like to give you one example, children, here. Suppose if the teacher says that the earth revolves around the sun, let us see how we change it into reported speech. The teacher says the earth revolves around the sun. Look at this example, children. Here, the teacher says the earth revolves around the sun. This is the example given here. This is known as reporting verb. And subject of the statement, teacher. And the earth revolves around the statement is the sentence is the statement given by the teacher. So, I have put it within the inverted commas. These are the characteristic features of the sentence. Yes, these are the characteristic features of the statement when we write in direct speech. As it is, without changing even a single word. Now, children, here, the earth revolves around the sun is the statement given by the teacher. And we put it within the inverted commas. and the subject here reporting verb is in present tense. So whenever the reporting verb is in present tense, there will be no change in the tense while changing into reported speech. Not only in this particular case, when suppose I would like to change here reporting verb in the same example, if I write it as said, here also there will be no change, children. Here also there will be no change. Why? Because it is the universal fact. The earth revolves around the sun is the universal fact. So whenever we want to change, universal facts or universal truths or principles or the statements given by the scientists, there will be no change even the reporting verb is in past tense. So keep it in your mind, children. Statement here, it is in verb 2. Reporting verb, but the same the teacher, said that the earth revolves around the sun. The earth revolves around the sun. Revolves around the sun, children. Is there any change? Look at this example. No change. The teacher said that the earth revolves around the sun. Just I deleted inverted commas and here I added one conjunction that. The teacher said that the earth revolves around the sun. No change. We have deleted inverted commas and we have added only just conjunction. So this applies only to universal facts. Yeah, universal truths. Principles and statements given by scientists. Keep these things in your mind. So we have to first look at the reporting verb while changing statement given into the reported speech. First have a look at the statement, whether it is a universal statement or the statement given by someone else. Unless it is universal fact or universal truth or principles or statements given by the statements, there will be change in the tense of the given sentence if the reporting verb is V2. Here, what changes take place? Let us see one by one. Here, children, we need to change different kinds of sentences into reported speech. I said two sentences are there, interrogatives are there, imperatives are there, and exclamatory sentences are there. And we again interrogative sentences here we have two types. Yeah, questions which start with the WH word, what, where, why, what, okay, bam, wherever, how, who, all these things. And sometimes we have questions that start with the helping verb. We use the helping verbs as question words also. We have many uses of these helping verbs, children. Suppose, let us take only one thing. As said two sentences in this session. We can go for all those different kinds of sentences in our later sessions one by one, children. Otherwise, you may get confusion. So, for our convenience, I would like to deal with the asset to sentences today, children. Now let us see one by one. Here, what have I said now? Yeah, whenever suppose if the statement given is not a universal fact or principle or the statement given by the scientist, then it changes into past tense. Present tense changes into past tense. Let us see one by one. What changes take place? Here, present simple changes into past simple. And past present continuous changes into past continuous. Present perfect changes into past perfect. Present perfect continuous changes into past perfect continuous. Let us see by examples, children. For our convenience, let us take four names. Ravi, Ramu, Geeta, Suma. Okay, children, let us come one by one. Ravi said to Ramu, I play cricket. It is quite common statement given by your friends, no children. Suppose if I ask you what games do you play, what do you say? I play cricket, I play chess, I play caroms, I play coco, I play kabaddi. Likewise, no children. Here, Ravi said to Ramu, I play cricket. See here, the statement is within the inverted commas. First, observe the statement. It's not a universal truth. It's not a principle given by any scientist, just by your friend. And look at the reporting verb. First case, look at the statement, whether it is a universal truth or fact, or the statement given by someone else. So it is a statement given by someone else. Now look at the reporting verb. What is the reporting verb here? Said. Is it in present tense or past tense? Yeah, it's in past tense. So I have told you just now, if the reporting verb is in past tense and it's not a fact, automatically the tense of this change, this sentence changes into past tense. Here, what is the tense of the sentence? V1. Play. I play cricket. It is a V1. Play. No? So here, Ravi said to Ramu that he played cricket. This is the reported speech. Here, and the first statement as it is given by Ravi, and the same thing is written on the board. And or some you may speak also. And change it into reported speech. So when we change it into reported speech, the tense changes in the given sentence from present tense to past tense. And now look at the subject, I. Who does the word I refer to here, children? Ravi. I refer to Ravi. So here what do we write? Third person. He. Ravi refers to boy, no? So I becomes he. Ravi said to Ramu that he played cricket. Why does this word he here? Because we are reporting Ravi's statement to you. Now Ravi is third person to us. I am talking to you. I am telling to you about Ravi's statement. Now Ravi is third person to us, no? So we used here he. He played cricket. Next, let us come to second. Ravi said to Geeta, I am writing English notes. Suppose if I ask you children, or if your friends ask you, what are you doing? What would be your answer? Yeah, I am writing my notes. I am writing my test. I am having my lunch. I am drinking water. I am reading. Yeah, I am reading my lesson. Likewise, no, children. So whatever the activity that you do at that particular set time, you use present continuous when your friends ask you about what you are doing. That means you describe the thing that you are doing. So we use then present continuous. So it's also quite common example that we come across in our daily life situation, children. You can use number of examples like this. You can write as many examples as possible in this present tense and try to change them in indirect speech. In the same way, here also, many of your friends say about your hobbies, no? I like fruits. Yeah, I like sweets. She likes biscuits. He likes chocolates. They play cricket. We play football. Likewise, you go on writing as many examples as possible in present simple and change them into reported speech. It automatically become perfect. Practice makes you perfect, children. Second example, present continuous. You can write as many examples as possible in this way. And let us see what changes take place while writing it in reported speech. Ravi said to Geeta, I am writing English notes. Ravi said to Geeta that he was writing English notes. Said, look at the sentence here. It's in present continuous. And next look at the reproaching verb. It is V2. So V2 means here the tense of the given sentence changes into past tense. What is the tense here? I am writing. It is in present continuous, children. So present continuous changes into past continuous. Just as I have said in the earlier example, here also hi. Who does the word hi refer to? Ravi. So we are reporting Ravi's statement again here. I refers to he. Ravi, no. So we, while reporting his statement, we, while writing it in indirect speech, we use Ravi. Yes, third person. He or he. As Ravi as third person. He was. Am becomes was. Am becomes was. Am writing. Was writing. English notes. No inverted commas. Don't put inverted commas in indirect speech, children. Okay. Next, let us have a look at the third example. Suma said to Ravi, I have returned your notes. Look at the example here. It's in present tense, present perfect tense. And look at the reporting verb. It is verb 2. So, Suma said to Ravi that I, who does the word I refer to? Suma. Now, we are reporting Suma's statement. So, it's not my statement or your statement, Suma's statement. So, automatically it becomes third person, children. Suma, in place of Suma, what do we write here? She. And she have returned becomes had returned. Present perfect becomes past perfect. His notes. Look here. Your notes. Your, who does the word you are referred to here? Ravi's notes. Yes. Your notes means she is saying to Ravi, no? Ravi's, your notes. Your always refers to, second person always refers to listener. Who is listener here? Ravi. So, your notes becomes Ravi's notes. Ravi's notes means here we write his notes. Okay, children, is it clear to you? You go on writing as many as examples possible in present perfect tense and change them in indirect speech. Next, look at the fourth example. Geeta said to Ravi, you have been studying here for 4 years. Look at the sentence here. The tense of the given sentence is present perfect continuous, and change it into reported speech. Here verb, reporting verb is verb 2. Geeta said to Ravi that he had been studying there for 4 years. You, who does the word you refer to? Listener. Who is listener here? Ravi. So in place of Ravi, we are using he, pronoun he. He have been studying becomes had been studying. Present perfect continuous changes into past perfect continuous. So he had been studying. Here becomes there. Here, what is this here? Adverb. Yes. Adverb of place. So here becomes there for 4 years. Here another change also take place. Adverbials of time, adverbials of place. And we shall go in detail about those changes also. Here becomes there now. It's adverb of time. It becomes then. Last year. And previous year. Yesterday. Previous day. The day before. Or we can say the day before. Tomorrow. The next day. Okay, children. Likewise, I shall give you the list of adverbial of places. And adverbial of times. And how they change while changing into reported speech in the later session, children. First, you keep all these points in your mind. First, look at the while changing direct speech into indirect speech, first look at the statement given there and what type of sentence it is. Is it a statement or a question or an order or an exclamatory mark? Okay, children. Next, second step, look at the, suppose if it's a SA2 sentence. Is it the statement given by scientists or is it a universal fact or a principle, universal truth? Or some statement given by someone else. Look at that. Suppose if it is not a universal fact or truth or a principle or statement given by scientists, look at the reporting verb. If the reporting verb is V1, no change take place in the statements. That means no change in the tense of the given sentence. If the reporting verb is V1, keep that point in your mind, children. If the reporting verb is V1, no change in the tense, children. there is no change in the tense if the reporting verb is V1. If the reporting verb is V2, what changes do take place? First, look at the statement and note the tense of the given sentence. Is it in present tense? Again, is it in simple, continuous, perfect or perfect continuous? If it is in simple sentence, present simple changes into past simple. If it is in present continuous, it changes into past continuous. If it is in present perfect, it changes into past perfect. If it is in present perfect continuous, it changes into past perfect continuous, children. Next, look at the speaker and listener. Who is the speaker and who is the listener? In the given statement, that means the sentence which we put within the inverted commas, I always refers to speaker. You always refers to listener. And at the same time, look at the subject and object given outside of the inverted commas. I always refers to speaker. You always refers to listener. And look at the gender, he or she. Accordingly, you have to change the pronouns within the inverted commas while changing them into reported speech, indirect speech. Children, just as we go in all these examples. Now, have you understood? If you feel any difficulty at understanding, pause the video and watch again. It's very clear, children. There is nothing difficult in understanding these kinds of sentences. We can change whatever the sentence given in direct speech into indirect speech very easily once you understand these facts. So go through all these examples once again, children, and for better understanding, you try to write your own examples, imagining the situations that what your friends say in present simple or present continuous or present perfect or present perfect continuous, children. Okay, now you change them in indirect speech. That's the assignment given to you, children. Okay, we shall go for other sessions later. Thank you. Keep on watching, children.